Good morning. I am Dr. Najma I, PG resident of Pushpagiri Institute of Medical Sciences and Research Center, Tiruvalla, Kerala. Here in my oral presentation on the paper title, Cross-sectional Imaging of Thoracic Lymphoma, a Pictorial Assay, I will be talking about various imaging findings of lymphoma patients based on few cases which came to our institution in the recent past. So when I reviewed the literature, lymphoma accounts for 4% of all cancers. In this, NHL accounts for 90% of all lymphomas, while HL constitutes the remaining 10%. The thorax is involved in 85% of all cases of HL and 45% of all cases of NHL. So distinguishing HL and NHL based on the imaging features and identifying the extranodal involvement are crucial because this affects the staging, treatment, as well as the prognosis. So aim of my study is to recognize the frequency of HL and NHL in patients presented with thoracic involvement and to provide further information about the imaging features of thoracic involvement of HL and NHL. So I reviewed the CT images of 10 lymphoma patients presented primarily with thoracic involvement at our institution in the recent past. Then imaging diagnoses were compared with the pathological report. Then assessed the frequency of HL and NHL and detailed the spectrum of radiological manifestations of lymphoma in the thorax. So coming to my discussion, this is my first case, a 24-year-old woman who presented with fatigue and weight loss. Further evaluation revealed anemia and multiple cervical lymph nodes. There's no history of tuberculosis. Her sputum AFB was negative and X-ray showed anterior mediastinal mass. So we took a CCT chest, which is showing multiple conglomerate lobulated heterogeneously enhancing soft tissue lesions involving the anterior mediastinum. It's HPR-KMS non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. In next case, a 67-year-old male presented with swelling in the right axil and right side of his chest. X-ray showed anterior mediastinal mass, CCT chest taken, which is showing homogeneously enhancing lobulated soft tissue lesion in the upper prevascular region of mediastinum with the necrotic areas. Then axial CCT chest images showing enhancing nodules in the anterior chest wall on the right side, as well as in the right pectoralis major with a few necrotic areas. It's HPR-KMS diffuse large B-cell lymphoma. Third case, a 32-year-old male presented with cough and breathing difficulty. Sputum AFP was negative. X-ray showed anterior mediastinal mass. Axial CCT chest images showing heterogeneously enhancing lobulated soft tissue lesion involving the prevascular space. Here is lesion. And coronal and axial CT chest in lung window showing areas of interlobular septal thickening, consolidation, and ground glass opacities involving the right middle lobe as well as the anterior segment of the left upper lobe. It's HPR-KMS Hodgkin's lymphoma. Next case, a 64-year-old male presented with chest wall and epigastric swelling and back pain. USG showed heterogeneous mass in the epigastrium. Axial CCT chest images showing heterogeneously enhanced lobulated soft tissue lesion involving the anterior mediastinum, which is indenting the cardia and anteriorly eroding the cephalosternum extending up to the subcutaneous plane. Sagittal CCT chest images showing lesion extending into the epigastrium and indenting the liver. Sagittal CT chest in bone window showing light lesion in D2 vertebral body. It's HPR-KMS non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. Then a 29-year-old male presented with cough and breathlessness. Chest X-ray showed homogeneous opacity in left upper zone. Axial CCT chest images showing heterogeneously enhancing soft tissue density lesion involving the prevascular space as well as in the left upper lobe, which is causing consolidation. Then these are the axial and coronal sections of CCT chest in lung window showing bronchus cutoff sign of left upper lobe bronchus. It's HPR-KMS Hodgkin's lymphoma. Sixth case, a 60-year-old male who presented with hoarseness of voice, dysphagia, and weight loss. USG showed multiple lymph nodal masses in bilateral cervical lymph node stations. Axial sections of CCT chest showing heterogeneously enhancing multiple discrete and conglomerate mediastinal and hilar lymph nodes. Axial CCT neck images showing evidence of right vocal cord palsy and in lung windows showing lymphangitis carcinomatosis. It's HPR-KMS non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. A 22-year-old male who presented with enlarged supraclavicular lymph nodes, X-ray showing mass in the right upper zone. CCT is just showing heterogeneously enhancing lobulator superficial lesion involving the anterior medial sternum. The C image, that is the third image, which is showing, which is taken after kikmo and radiotherapy, and showing the showing significant resolution. Its HPR came was Hodgkin's lymphoma. Next case, a 23-year-old male who presented with breathlessness, X-ray just showing anterior mediastinal mass. Axial and coronal CCD chest images showing heterogeneously enhancing lobulator superficial lesion involving the pre-vascular space. This is where came as Hodgkin's lymphoma. Next case, a 78-year-old male, female who presented with breathing difficulty, cough, and for 1 week, just a fever was present. CCD chest images showing heterogeneously enhancing mediastinal lymph nodes, bilateral pleural effusion, and a pleural thickening on both sides. This HPR came as Hodgkin's lymphoma. Last case, a 25-year-old female who presented with a fever, cough, and breathlessness. Axial sections of CCD just showing non-enhancing pattern of right lung field with few patchy areas of normally enhancing lung tissue and a pleural effusion. Coronal CT in chest in lung window showing complete collapse of right lower lobe. Its HPR came as Hodgkin's lymphoma. So in 10 lymphoma patients who presented with thoracic involvement, 6 were diagnosed as HL and 4 were diagnosed as NHL. Most of them have an overlap of imaging findings. And all of those 10 patients have mediastinal involvement. In addition to that, 5 possess pulmonary involvement, 2 possess pleural involvement, and 2 possess chest wall involvement. So I came to a conclusion that there is a distinct overlap between thoracic manifestations of HL and NHL. However, the study proved that image findings are an imperative part in accurately differentiating lymphomas and recognizing the frequency of thoracic involvement. So these are my references. Thank you.